Last episode, we looked at how capacitance can affect your electronics. In this episode, we're going to look at the three different effects that inductance can have on your circuits. Hi, and welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to use an oscilloscope to look at the three different effects that an inductor can have in an electronic circuit. The first effect of inductance is that it stores energy in the form of a magnetic field. So to look at that, we have my oscilloscope piping out a square wave from my function generator through a resistor, and we're going to add an inductor in series to see how that changes my signal. So with our series inductor, you can see these spikes show up on the oscilloscope screen. And what's happening is when the signal is low, the inductor is charging up, and as soon as the signal switches high, it's pushing that energy back into the system, and that turns up as a spike on the screen. The second effect of inductance is that it filters out frequency. It's going to filter out the high frequency signals and let the low signals pass through it as if it were a wire. So for the higher frequency components of my square wave input, we can see that the inductor is actively working against that change, but over time the inductor is going to charge up all the way and more or less act as a short circuit. The third effect of inductance is that it changes the phase relationship between voltage and current. And if we look at my oscilloscope, channel 1 is my voltage, channel 2 is my current, and you can see my oscilloscope is measuring a roughly 20 degree difference between voltage and current. In an ideal world, it should be 0 degrees because I'm just measuring a resistor, but there's some built-in parasitic inductance and capacitance in my circuit. To learn more, check out the video identifying parasitic inductance. There's a card for that and there's a link for it in the description. We talk about the built-in inductance in this type of setup and also the step response of inductors and capacitors in an AC world. So let's look at what happens when I include my inductor in my circuit. We're gonna see a pretty significant phase relationship change between voltage and current. And we can see that my voltage is now leading my current. I see a 90 degree phase shift measured on my oscilloscope.
And I can tell that my voltage is leading because the rising edge of my voltage happens earlier in time than the rising edge of my current. So my current is lagging or my voltage is leading.
That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, hit the thumbs up button. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. And if you want to get better at using oscilloscopes, download the free ebook, 6 Essential Tips for Getting the Most Out of Your Oscilloscope. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and I will see you next time.